If you are interested in your PST files, then this is the video for you. I'm going to show you how to get all the PST data online. That means from any device, including mobile apps, you'll be able to access it and search it. So let's see how this is done. Short answer first, move all the mails and whatever else you want from the old PSTs to your main mailbox. Look at this table. Except for the last two items, all other Microsoft 365 or Office 365 licenses have at least 50 GB mailbox. So generally there is no need to put that PST in OneDrive or find some workaround or put it on some archive. It can fit into your main mailbox. First step is to know how big is your mailbox. Let's start with old version of Outlook. File menu, it shows you the mailbox size and how much is free, how much is occupied. If you want to try the same thing on the new version of Outlook, go to this wheel, then go to Accounts, Storage. There's a drop down because you can have multiple accounts. Choose the correct account and then you will see available space as well as total space. On browser version also, similar steps. Go to the wheel and look at the storage. Now let's talk about the PST. I'm going to take one PST as an example and show you what to do with it. Follow the same process for other PSTs as well. All this PST operation has to be done in the old version of Outlook on the desktop. Go to the file menu and then go to open and export, and then you can open that PST. By default, it only shows mail folders. Ideally, this is old data. You would like to see all folders. How do you do that? Go to the menu on the left side or sometimes on the bottom and look at other options. You will see an option called folders. Once you go there, you will see all the folders. The next thing is to compact the file. Right click on the PST file, data file properties, advanced. Click on compact now. Depending on the size, it may take some time, but it's going to reduce the file size. The next thing to do is to understand what are the contents of this PST and how much space different folders are occupying. So click on folder size. This will give you a list. Just eyeball the list and identify folders which are really relevant to you even today. For example, deleted items are occupying 21 MB of space. I deleted them in 2003, so why would I want them now? Doesn't make sense. So this will help you identify the important items which you want to retain for future. In our main mailbox, we'll create one folder for all the backward data, all the past data. I've created a folder called old PSTs. And then you may have 1 or 20 PSTs, whatever it is. All those should be put under the old PST folder so that we have one place to go to. The problem is we cannot multi-select folders. We have to do it one by one. And that's going to be a laborious process. Second, there are going to be a lot of items to copy. So it's going to take time and it may fail. If it fails, you'll have to copy again. And if you do that, duplication will occur. So let's handle these problems upfront. First thing I'm going to do is go to the PST and create a folder. So give this folder a sensible name. This folder I'm going to copy to the main mailbox. The next step is to move all the data into this folder. I want this folder to go under this. So simple drag drop. That is going to move. Some special folders like inbox, you cannot move. So what do you do? While dragging and dropping, press the control key or right click on this and say copy folder and choose this folder. So do this for all the folders which you want to keep online. And let's assume this folder is now ready with all the data which needs to go into our main mailbox. And I have this folder called old PSTs, which is ready to receive it. But however compelling it is to just drag drop, please do not do it. Why not? Because if this drag drop fails, what will you do? You will start it all over again and there'll be duplication. So fortunately for us, there is a way to copy data and prevent duplication while doing it. Now this PST I have already prepared, so I'm going to close it. I know we have not copied the data yet. Still, I'm going to close it. Choose the correct folder, old PSTs. Now go to File, Open and Export. And this time, Import Export. Import from another file, yes. It is a PST file. And this is very important. Replace duplicates? No, do not import duplicates. So now it's saying which folder to import from. I wish it could have multi-select, but it doesn't give multi-select. We have already handled that problem by creating one folder which has all the folders which we need. And that's why we should include subfolder. And where do we want to import it? Import items in the current folder. That's why we selected old PST. And then click on Finish. That's how you do it, one PST at a time. Now, depending on the size, it may take a long time. Do it as the last activity of your day and leave the machine on. What is the result now? All our past data is in the main mailbox. It's going to be available for searching and any type of use live. Even on mobile phone, you will be able to search and find these mails. Do you know the most efficient way to use Outlook? The most efficient way is to use Outlook less. Yes, why am I saying that? Oh, because Outlook is not alone. It's a part of Office 365. Office 365 or Microsoft 365 has 25 plus apps. One of them is Outlook. Why are there other apps? Because they do certain things very well. So we have to start using the right app in the right place. And that's what I specialize in. I work with organizations and help them optimize and transform efficiency across the board. So if you're interested in doing that, let me know. My email ID is in the description. And of course, about this video, let me know if it worked for you. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them and share it with as many people as you can. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.